Rish.
Shalom, shalom.
Got a topic for the day.
Topic for the day. It's house Negroes.
House niggas.
Boulay.
Uncle Tom's.
Niggas.
Black O'Face.
Tribe of Yahudah back at you again.
Shalom, shalom.
Okay, we're gonna speak on just these Boulay and these Negroes is keeping us going, keeping this oppression going, and playing the devil's advocate. We're gonna go with one scripture out of the Bible. We're gonna go to Luke
20:19-20. It said, and the chief priests and the scribes that same hour sought to lay hands on him, and they feared the people, for they perceived that he had spoken this parable against them, and they watched him and sent for spies, which should feign themselves just men, that they might take hold of his words, that so they might deliver him unto the power and authority of the governor.
Okay, so this scripture right here is speaking on the Messiah, which was a black man. Okay, we're going to fast forward this to Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, particularly Malcolm X. Okay, who killed Malcolm X? So-called people within the Nation of Islam. Okay, they came in, they spied them out, they dressed themselves up, they worked with the government, but they tied themselves on to the Nation of Islam and came amongst that man playing his bodyguard, but they were spying out for the CIA and got this man killed. So here, right here, out the scriptures, out the Bible, how we can tie ourselves to our history book here, not no religious book, but our history book, and see that it actually happened with the Messiah. Also Nat Turner, also Marcus Garvey. He's always a devil's advocate or a boule or some Negro within our organization that's working for our enemy, our oppressor. So this video right here is basically towards y'all, man. You know what I'm saying? Y'all gotta keep your circles tight. You know what I'm saying? And check everybody in your circle, man. You know what I'm saying? Because we ain't got time to be playing around. You know what I'm saying? We need to spot them out as quick as we can and get them out of there, because we're going to have spies. We're going to have Judases around here, man. You know what I'm saying? It's going to try to take us up, take us out, and take us away from our mission, which is to liberate our people. You know what I'm saying? For our sisters, for the children out here, man. It's time for us to stand the fuck up as black men. You know what I'm saying? And take our rightful spot. You know, but we got to have to take a whole lot of... We talk a lot about the white man and all that, but we speaking more towards these Negroes out here today. You know, these Negroes who love America.
Come up with the concept here at home and then they outsource labor on another continent.
Ambassador, is this the new revolution? Can it sustain this economy?
You know, I think Joe makes some good points, but there's some important things we need to remember. The first is that the U.S. is still a major manufacturing power. We still manufacture more goods than any other country in the world. A lot of people think China's the biggest manufacturer in the world. That's not true. It's still the United States. Now, it is true that manufacturing employment in the United States has gone down. That's because our technology's improved and we can make stuff with fewer people than we used to be able to. But those people that used to do manufacturing jobs now have opportunities to work in other sectors, like the technology sector, like the healthcare sector, things that are in high demand and are growth industries in the United States. The challenge for us is to make sure that we don't leave any segments of our population or even any individuals behind as we move forward to take advantage of this technological revolution. We need to make sure that people are getting quality education. We need to make sure that they have the opportunity to step out and take advantage of what's going on in the U.S. economy.
You know, we had Scott from the American Manufacturers on a few weeks ago, and he said that China had overtaken the United States in manufacturing, but you refute that.
I do refute that. Not yet. That might happen at some time, and if it does, frankly, who cares? Because the important thing is that someone's out there producing these goods and services, and as long as Americans have jobs that enable them to purchase those goods and services, that means we're all better off in the end.
You know, when you listen to this conversation, you forget that America is in a downward economic spiral.
Well, I think you have to put that in context. America is the richest country, not only in the world today, but in the history of the world. And we have had so much economic growth and progress, and not just for the rich. This is progress throughout our society as a whole, that if we have a little recession or a retraction in growth for a little while, that still can leave us way above where we were 15 or 20 years ago.
Let me tell you how true that is. I was just in Lagos, Nigeria, and I want to tell you this. They're 200 years behind us. It would take them 250 years just to catch up. That statement is so true. It has never been more relevant to me than when I was in Lagos recently. I realized, you know, we don't have problems. This is what I came back saying. You're exactly right. And if you look, put it in perspective, if you're comparing yourself to Americans, we're in trouble. But outside these borders, it's a real world that exists. And you're right. Not only are we the richest nation in the world, I don't think anybody will ever come close to matching what we have been able to build as a nation in such a short amount of time.
It's perspective, and it's all relative.
Back in the day, when Master was sick, you know, the house Negro said, "Master, we sick."
Sick?
You know what I'm saying? It's the same damn shit going on, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm feeling well. You know what I'm saying? Who's the field niggas? You know what I'm saying? We feeling well. We trying to get up in there to bust Master ass. You know what I'm saying? Like our brother Nat Turner, who read those scriptures and was enlightened and said, "Yo, devil don't live on the ground. Devil don't have no horns, goddammit. The devil's in that motherfucking house right now. And who with me? We gonna go out here and bust his ass, man. You know what I'm saying? We gonna go move on to the next plantation. And we're going to bust their ass, and whoever ain't with us. Just like our queen, the Queen Harriet Tubman, who put the gun to the slave's head and said, "If you ain't with me, you don't want to go with me, I'm going to put this goddamn bullet in your head. I'm going to kill you right on the spot if you ain't with me." You know what I'm saying? So, and then turn around, house Negro. Tells on him. You know what I'm saying? Go tell on Nat Turner, our brother Nat Turner. Nat Turner the great, man. You know, they found out using those scriptures, that same scripture that your pastors are using. House Negroes, man. You know what I'm saying? These false-ass damn shepherds, man, leading our people straight right to the slaughterhouse. You know what I'm saying? Taking our money. I ain't telling you what's going on in this Bible right here. You know, so to the family out here, we need to open our eyes. You know, anybody telling you to bow down to this system and you need to do this and cut your hair off and shave and all this, you know, and try to push you away from your black identity or whatever, you know, sit they ass down, man, because they trying to make you bow. You know, we gotta come out of that. So, anybody else wanna say?
Good point. Good point. Shalom, shalom. I would pose a question is, if you ain't speaking revolution, what you speaking, nigga? Except for you know your enemies and yet you eating with them. And by that I simply mean, just look at the so-called timeline of our history here. Not just around the world, because those that do their research know that we go back at least 400,000 years. But on that note, just the history of being here. Whatever you consider mundane or the normality of good here, how good has it been over the last 400 years? And look at where you're at. Now, there's one thing to progress forward in liberation, and there's another to believe that you're marching forward in freedom. And again, like, I hate to keep seeing so redundant, but to talk about this, you know what I'm saying, Trayvon Martin case. Yet again, had this been on the reverse end, had Trayvon Martin been on that that community watch and he followed Zimmerman and he shot him, he would have no bail. And he would have been detained. PayPal accounts would have been seized, whatever. So how good is your standing here? Are you realizing that you're still slaves? Hell, just a couple of years ago, you were about to lose your right to vote again. And my thing is, why don't anybody ask the questions of why? Why systematically does everything seem harder for me? Yes, there are a few that slip through the crack. There are. And I guess these are the ones that I speak to the most, because we do have a lot of Uncle Thomas's in our midst. Those that can do, don't do, and those that will do, more than likely aren't able.
Or being bought out.
Yeah. It's very sad when our leaders are for sale. Especially those that we are supposed to confide in or believe in, because technically, no matter how you slice it, dice it, parade, or shred it, you were brought here as package. Hence the reason why you have a packaging ID number called your social security number. You feel me? Your chattel property, your own. You came here as property. Your ancestors came here as property.
And everybody failed to realize that. Mm-hmm.
Nobody accepts the fact that how can you ever, first is a dual-sided question. How can you consider yourself equal to something than you are better than? And firstly, well, I guess more so secondly, how can you even feel that you will be treated equally in a land of where you were brought here to be less than? Now, the CIA came up when the brother Marcus Garvey was here, you know what I'm saying, and bringing so-called Pan-Africanism to America, to the Negroes, letting us know who we were. The CIA came out with something called what? Anybody remember? Anybody know? I give you a second to guess.
I got one thing.
So yes. I got two.
You mind show your face right quick?
Oh my God.
Oh, just show your face right quick. I promise.
I did not come to be the female model. I just wanted some water.
No.
That's all.
Listen, you see this highly melanated sister right here? You know what I'm saying?
I know what that means.
I know, baby.
I'm black as hell.
No. Don't be no disrespect. Because we got to get that. That's the point I'm trying to make. You know what I'm saying? This is the queen of the goddamn planet Earth right here. You know what I'm saying? Everybody came from this sister right here. You know what I'm saying? You go outside at night, the sky is black, goddammit. You know what I'm saying? You look up, the sky is black as midnight. You feel what I'm saying? This is the queen of the motherfucking planet, and this is how we're going to protect her. You feel what I'm saying?
Oh, Lord.
You know what I'm saying? By Yahweh, by Hashimah, Mashiach, Yahweh Shah. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody going to put no hands on this sister right here, or any of my sisters out there. You know? I mean, I'm Hebrew Israelite. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to come off like this thug, all this. No, this is real, man. You know what I'm saying? I want to protect my sisters. I want to protect the babies. You know what I'm saying? And get off this goddamn light-skinned, mulatto damn shit they showing on damn TV right now. All they showing our people. They ain't showing these sisters like this right here. You know what I'm saying? They ain't showing this sister. This sister got to go around and hear, you too damn black. Everybody comes from black. You know what I'm saying? If you want to grow anything, you throw seeds in Africa on the ground, and that ground is black. I mean, it's fertile. You feel what I'm saying? So we don't protect our sisters out here. You know what I'm saying? Y'all sit your ass down, because we got brothers out here, the Most High, raising up to protect these sisters, man.
You know,
y'all going to sit down, you know what I'm saying? And just play the background.
That's right.
Man. You know what I'm saying? Just play the background, man, and watch this stuff happen, man. Black liberation.
Peace.
Black liberation. But yeah, this plan was issued, and the whole purpose of it was to prevent the rise of a black messiah. Now, if you look it up, it's called the COINTELPRO. Okay? So with that peaking, which that happened around 1935, a little bit after 1935 to be exact. You know what I'm saying? But with that, it basically titles, which came from your Congress, your government, that said that it would put a stop to any black messiah. Now, firstly, look up the definition of messiah. Mm. A savior, a black savior, so to speak. Okay? Now, then you have Martin Luther King in the era of Malcolm, Brother Malcolm. You know what I'm saying? Now, a lot of people say that civil rights were acts that were passed more so by Martin Luther King, but they were done by legislators, which is a part of Congress, which is a part of government. Okay? So my purpose of asking and getting to the point that I'm making, house niggas, is, and I mean all my people, actually, because this question goes a little farther than just house niggas. How can you ever succeed in a place where they've already put a cap on you?
Okay.
So what should you do? Because marching and picket signs and buying hoodies and Skittles and talking about what you would like to do but don't do on Facebook, or as my brother calls it, Facebook, For some reason, a million motherfuckers are gangsta on Facebook, but when this shit hits the door, watch how many of them bitch out and just lay there and take it and die, because that's what they've been taught and trained to do. If you want freedom, stop being dumb first and search for how to be free. Never in the history of the entire world or any universe has freedom ever been attained by talking about what you're going to do. Every revolutionary war, every civil war, we bared arms. Our arms were bared.
Blood was shed.
Blood was shed. So you think about that when you talking about rallying, or you walking, or you buying hoodies and Skittles. If you want it, what's really stopping you from going to go get it? If liberation is on the horizon or on the top of them hills, how many of y'all are willing to go get it? Point blank, period. Black liberation.
Let me see that real quick. Whenever you get down.
Explain
how's
Negro. House Negro for them. What a house nigga, a house nigga is, so you know the difference.
Because the house you know Negro is the one that sits right by his enemy and tell on his own people all the time. The one who's close to his master and tell on the rest of the people. I'm about to read it for you.
And on a double aspect, one who terrorizes his own people.
You want to try?
I'm out of the same scripture we just read a while ago. That Luke 20. It said, and they watched them and sent forth spies which had feigned themselves just men. Come at you like they righteous men. That they might take hold of his words. You might actually believe him. That so they might deliver him unto the power and authority of the governor. He did all that. He gonna come at you with the good words, make you believe him.
And you give him up.
And his whole purpose is to deliver you into the power and authority of the government. And we got to ask ourselves, man, like, okay, we had a lot of people who came and tried to get us out of this bondage that we in. Why are we still here, man? It got to be something going on that's keeping us separated from our objective in the first place, which is to get back to where we was at before we was even taken. But it's a reason why we still here.
Right.
Somebody got to be getting tricked.
Yep.
It can't be like, okay, I look at it like this right here. From what I just read, that house Negro is damn near, is more deadlier than the white man. Because the white man got to catch, we know what he going to do. It's the one that come at you with, that look like you, with the good words, you know.
Flash your talk.
You know, coming at you like a just man.
Look like a duck. Walk like a duck, you know, like a duck, but it's a snake.
It's a snake, and he gonna deliver you.
Got a tail.
He gonna deliver you to the government.
Push back,
and we see that all the time. We see that all the time. So my thing is this right here, man. We gotta get out of that. We all for ourselves. Everybody for themselves, man. We gotta come together, man. That's the only way we gonna do it.
Throw some unity in your community.
That's the only way, and it can't be like one man is the head power, man. Like when you got, take for example, all these organizations is built like a pyramid. It's one man at the top, or it's a few men at the top. But the thing is, if you let them get all the power, then it ain't gonna be equality at the bottom, because you got the people at the top with the majority of the resources. So how the people at the bottom gonna feel like they eating right? So my thing is this, man, we gotta get out of that every man for themselves shit, man. That's my thing, man. As soon as we got out of that, I mean, it'll be a lot better. Like, all the money we get from income tax, how much money do y'all think we get from income tax every year? Now, how much money do you think we spend all that income tax money on just little dumb stuff, man?
Flat screen TV.
How much that spent on actually trying to do something for your community?
Yeah, for your community. And imagine if everybody just put $1 in the pot. Just $1. Income tax money, you get about $5,000.
Yeah.
You claiming other people's kids.
Yeah. Keep it real.
Keep it real.
Yeah, for real. And you got all this money and you buying rims for your cars.
Flat screen
TVs.
Jewelry.
Well, come on, man, jewelry.
Person not neighborhood. You know what I'm saying? Go get a car and ride around with 30-day damn tags, man.
For 5 months, damn.
Come on, son. You know what I'm saying?
Come on.
And got
man.
A flat 72-inch TV.
In the crib.
Come on, man.
Got two cars. Both of them got 30 days.
30-day tags.
Which ain't nothing wrong with M. you. If you
nah. I ain't saying ain't nothing wrong right. with it. Well, my thing is this right here. Why did you spend so much money at one time and you ain't got no way to
get the tags?
No, you
can't afford it.
Right. You didn't blow out your
30-day tags is about 4 or 5 months.
Well, you could have started up a little business or doing something to where you could buy you a little car but start something, man. That way you can generate money.
Own something.
You know?
Notice how many people have stores in your community that don't look like you.
Come on, man. How many stores do we own in our community, man?
None.
Besides barbershops and clothing stores. We might sell clothes, might cut some hair, man. But I'm talking about stores that make money off many different things, like Walmart's. Something like that. Well, we got many different things that we sell.
And they're gonna break bread, bro.
Yeah, and we got so much talent in our community, man, we can do that.
Sure can. Everybody else know everybody raping us.
But they scared.
We got people that do everything. We do everything. Make soap, do your electrician work, plumbing, all that stuff. We can build our own stuff, man. But what we do? We wanna work for somebody, man.
Every time.
That's what
this
we
right here. I want to go back from the other video and speak on the Martin Luther King thing. You know, I love Martin Luther King, but it was just a point that we gotta abide by the laws and the scriptures of Yahweh, or the Most High Yahweh. You know what I'm saying? I know we come with vulgar words or whatever. We from the street, man. You know what I'm saying? I ain't no pastor. I ain't got no church. You know what I'm saying? I don't want your money. I just want you to open your ears up. You know what I'm saying? Pastor wants your money. He gonna talk smooth words to you. So I'm gonna come to you vulgar, cause I'm from the street. You know what I'm saying?
That.
And I can't get that out of me, but I'm righteous though. Don't think I'm not righteous because I might say a so-called cuss word. You know what I'm saying?
Cuss word.
Damn English is a damn curse word. You know what I'm saying? We curse speaking English. We ain't speaking our original language no more. You feel what I'm saying?
Come on.
And when your lines are together, what they call it? Cursive.
So I'm gonna go back to.
Okay, what word?
You're writing it together,
right?
That's how that's. And you're writing it in English or Latin, maybe some Spanish.
You're writing
but
and
it's cursive.
Together. That's cursive.
Curse.
What do you think you do when you put a bunch of letters together or characters of letters together to form a word? It's called spelling.
Writing spells. Man.
Understand what you do and where you're at when you're in a fallen system. I'm sorry, brother.
No, you go ahead, bro.
Right, go ahead.
It's that spirit, man. I like to hear it. All right, we're going to go to the book of the brother Jeremiah.
Yeah.
This is chapter 23:25. This is coming off from the last video. Okay, this is Martin Luther King right here in the scriptures. You know this book was not written when Martin Luther King was living. So we're trying to prove to you that there is a creator that inspired righteous men to speak, okay? And write these words down because he already saw Martin Luther King coming. He said, I have heard what the prophet said. That prophesy lies in my name, saying, I have dreamed. We know Martin Luther King had a dream, okay? Mm-hmm. All right, he said, how long shall this be in the heart of the prophets that prophesy lies? He asked the question. He said, yeah. And his lingo was so much like us.
Yeah,
if y'all read that scripture, the Most High speak just like us, all right? He said, they are prophets of deceit of their own heart, which think to cause my people to forget my name by their dreams. And Martin Luther King, everybody know he was a pastor. He had a church, he had a congregation. And he said, Lord, a whole lot. And we told y'all, and I'm going to show you it again because when I saw the video, it didn't really come up on the video that clear. So I want to be able to show that again, that bow means Lord. Okay. Bow. The word means Lord or Master. Bow. Okay? So everybody say Lord Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, you calling on bow. Okay? And it says the term was used as a name for a native god of the land of Canaan. A farm and fertility god. So it didn't really come up on the video that clear. So I want to be able to show that again that bow means Lord. Okay? He said,
which they tell every man to his neighbor, as their fathers have forgotten my name, for bow, meaning Lord. So everybody don't say bow no more. Everybody say
Lord.
Lord. So everybody say, they still saying bow though.
I got
okay?
you real quick, brother.
Go ahead.
Bow. Lord of Canaanite religion and seen in the thunderstorm. Baal was worshipped as a god who provided fertility. He proved a great temptation for Israel. Baal occurs in the Old Testament as a noun meaning Lord, owner, possessor, or husband.
Okay, now you got it right here. In the last video, we were speaking around Easter time. Mm-hmm. So I told you about Easter bunny, meaning fertility. Uh-huh. Okay, and then what is fertility? The six. Then you got Hugh Hefner in the Playboy Mansion with a damn
bunny.
That's a Playboy bunny. So, okay, we bringing it to you. Okay, so the prophet that hath a dream, let him tell a dream. Mm. And he that hath my word, let him speak my word faithfully, which we are doing right now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now we're going to jump to Deuteronomy 13:5.
I'm going to go back to that too when you get done.
Okay. Go to Deuteronomy 13:5. And this is what's going to happen to that prophet. Because everybody like, okay, who assassinated Martin Luther King? Who killed Martin Luther King? White man killed Martin Luther King. No, he didn't. We're about to tell you who killed Martin Luther King. Okay? Now, like I said, I love the brother. So, I mean, whatever y'all feel about what I'm saying around, I don't care. I'm just reading my father's word. Okay? He said, okay, Deuteronomy 13:5. He said, and that prophet. Uh-huh. Now, we came for you from Jeremiah. Okay? We came from Jeremiah. Jeremiah way back here.
Yeah.
We're going to show you this right quick. How far Jeremiah away? Jeremiah's here. That's how much in between. So we're going to Deuteronomy. He said, and that prophet, or that dreamer of dreams, shall be put to death, because he had not spoken to turn you away from your Hold up. Part itself. I'm going to start all over. And that prophet, or that dreamer of dreams, shall be put to death, because he has spoken to turn you away from Yahweh, that mighty one, which brought you out of the land of Egypt, which was Kemet, okay? Which was Kemet in Africa. We were in slavery in Africa. And redeemed you out of the house of bondage. Mm. Egypt means bondage. Egypt means slavery. Alexander changed the name of Kemet from Kemet to Egypt, meaning bondage, because he knew the history of that. Okay, and redeem you out of the house of bondage to thrust thee out of the way which Yahweh thy mighty one commanded thee to walk in.
Mm.
So shalt thou be put the evil away from the midst of thee. So the Most High took Martin Luther King out. You know, it was a white man that did it. You know what I'm saying? Jesse Jackson might have had something to do with it too. Because when he came out on that balcony, and he had an argument with Jesse Jackson early that day, and Jesse called him out there, and he was talking to Jesse off that balcony, and next thing you know, he was popped. You know what I'm saying? So, who's to say Jesse Jackson wasn't doing that COINTELPRO we just read out of Luke? You know what I'm saying? Being that spot. You know? So, you know, we got to look at this thing, man. You know, I mean, is everybody in this conscious thing for the money? Are you in it for popularity? Are you in to go out and travel these different cities and lecture and make money off the people? Because we're not about that, man. I just want everybody to open their ears. I don't want your damn money. You know what I'm saying? If you send a donation to me or whatever, all well, man, I got to eat too. You know what I'm saying? But I don't want your money. I ain't trying to get rich off of this, man. You know what I'm saying? I know how to make money. You put something up here.
Prosper, I said.
I'm saying, but I ain't asking you for the money, so I'm not the pastor. I just want y'all to hear these words of wisdom that the Most High placed into us to give to the family out there, man. This is out of love. You know what I'm saying? Stop going to these churches again, rape. You know what I'm saying? I mean, damn, I done got robbed plenty of times with a pistol, and I know how that feel. But y'all go to church and he just speak these smooth words, and damn, you just come out your damn pockets. You know what I'm saying? Collection plate, and you try to outdo the next man. You know, he put $20 in there. I'm going to put $100 in there. No, you got to pay your damn light bill, man. You feel stupid next week because you're thinking that the Lord Jesus Christ is going to pay your damn light bill. You know what I'm saying? And it's not going to happen because the Most High ain't going to deal with no fools, man.
Or you go to heaven, or you go to heaven by just paying.
Go ahead,
bro. You brought that up, bro. Now, what I'm reading from here is, this is an illustrated Bible dictionary, a Holman's version. So, and this, the reason why I'm saying this is because a lot of our viewers and whatnot, and for many new viewers that we may have and see, if you hear us and you hear what we talk about, we speak the name Yahweh, Yahweh, okay, as the one you call God. And y'all look, some of y'all look at us when we talk to you and so whatever. Because, I mean, I know 9 times out of 10, we've run into a few of y'all, you know. And y'all look at us like some of, like I had an old woman who was like, you a blasphemous. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Because I speak my father's true name.
Right.
All right? Mm-hmm. So, as you were just speaking about, you know what I'm saying, the preacher and how they prophesy lies or so whatever, the one thing that they don't keep G with you is the name of your creator.
Right.
All right? So what I'm going to read to you here is a little spot where it says nature of God. Okay? I'm going to read it till about where it mentions Exodus chapter 3, verse 13. All right? It says the nature of God. Scripture identifies and describes God in many ways across the entire canon of Scripture. All right? And our understanding of him must be based in a total presentation of himself in all the scriptures. In other words, in all of the book, how he references himself, how he says to call my name. You know what I'm saying? There is something that he wants to be called, how he presented himself.
Right.
All right? So to move along further with that, as it says, however, for our purposes, we will attempt to summarize the sweep of biblical data by the words, God, the covenant Lord. First, God is the Lord. And you see that's in quotations because that's by our, as it talks in Jeremiah or Jeremiah about how our people forsake our father's name for Baal or Lord. You'll never find that in the original scripts talking about us, our people, bruh, or sus. But anyway, moving on. It says, even though Yahweh is not the only name of the God of God in Scripture, it is uniquely the name by which God identifies himself. Mm. If you would, zoom up on that, brother. Make show them I ain't just spitting this out my opinion, you know. Hold on. Let's get it right there. You know what I'm saying? It's your God.
Let him get time to zoom it in.
Uh-huh.
Last time.
All right. Now, with that being said and done, in other words, if he's giving you his name and you call him another name that is not his, what are you calling? And why aren't the people in the pulpit, the ones that are supposed to be the shepherds of the sheep, not telling the name? If the whole book references to him calling or us calling him his name, then why do we constantly say that we know him or we strive to know him, yet we call him the wrong name?
Right.
If your name is Peter and I call you John, are you going to respond?
Why would
it? And then my dad, rough dude, you know what I'm saying? I'm not going to call him something, a whole nother name, you know what I'm saying? I might get smacked down, you know what I'm saying? I'm a grown man now, and I still ain't going to call my dad out his name. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to call my dad his name, but I know him my dad's name. That's the point I'm trying to make. You know what I'm saying? But he's not going to allow me to give him another name. You know what I'm saying? Nobody in this table right here, anybody in this room is going to allow somebody to call them something that they're not. You know what I'm saying? How can I, you know...
House niggas will.
And they'll do it all day. You know what I'm saying? Whatever master call
me. At this table.
You know what I'm saying?
House niggas will.
That's what it is. That's what it is, man. You know, we got to start, we got to take these names off of us as well, too. Because these names, we go overseas, like we said in another video. We go overseas, and somebody in the African tribe ask us, what's your name? You know what I'm saying? Have enough English in their mind to say, what's your name? And we say, damn, Tyrone Jenkins or something. They're going to look at you like you're crazy. They're going to walk the hell away from you. Because what the hell does Tyrone Jenkins mean?
Pet.
You know what I'm saying?
Owned.
Your name is Ariyah bin Yahudah is my name. My brother right here. My brother here.
Siddiqiyah.
We have names named after our father. You know what I'm saying? Just like the Messiah, he said, I came in the name of my father. You know what I'm saying? So it's the attributes. It's the attribute. Your attribute of Yahweh is Yahweh's. Yahweh is strength. Yah is strength. Yahweh. You know what I'm saying? He's giving you characteristics of his name. You know, I'm strength. I'm justice. You know what I'm saying? I'm nourisher. You know, it's different. There's attributes to their name. So, you know, you go overseas and you say that, they say, oh, okay, brother, welcome, no, welcome, brother. They're going to take you in because of your name. And then they're going to watch you and see if you carry on those attributes of that name. Like the Messiah came in the name of Yahweh Shah. He came in the Father's name, meaning Yahweh redeems, Yahweh saves, Yahweh salvation. You know what I'm saying? So when he said, my name is Yahweh Shah, people sat back and watched and observed him. And he fulfilled his attribute of his name. You know, so we got to start taking these white man, these slave names off of us, man. My last name is damn Holler. You know what I'm saying? So who the hell owned my damn family? The damn Dutch. I ain't no fucking Dutch. You know what I'm saying?
It's no. Like Dutch master.
I'm not going around calling man Holland. No. Dutch masters. You know what I'm saying? Brother smoke Dutch masters and my last name Holland. You know what I'm saying?
You had a real Dutch master, bro.
A real Dutch master. Man, hallelujah. You know what I'm saying? We try to bring it to the family out here as simple as we can, man. You know what I'm saying? We ain't gonna go high, so high intellectual with you or whatever. I said we ain't dealing with metaphysics. But if metaphysics is necessary sometimes, to, you know, to some people. But to the family out there that's being led astray, man, you know, a whole lot of family deep down in church and deep down in these different religions and all this, don't know exactly what's going on, and we come to them, they've been sleeping dead and gone for so long, we try to wake them up and revive them and resurrect them and try to shed this light on them, and they look at us like we crazy as hell, you know what I'm saying, and push us away, you know what I'm saying, out of the circle, whatever, and all we doing is trying to get love, man. It's very tiresome. You know what I'm saying? It's very tiresome what we go through, man. We go through a lot of damn stress, depression, you know what I'm saying? But that don't mean I'm goddamn stop though. You know what I'm saying? That don't stop nothing. You know what I'm saying? Cause soon as I get around my brothers, get around my family, you know what I'm saying? Everybody feeling the same way. You know, get around the air lights or whatever, you know what I'm saying? We get the building, that energy, you know, get refurbished, you know, get revived. I get revived being around my family, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, to the people out there just coming to the knowledge, you know what I'm saying? Get with somebody that, you know, is thinking, you know, about like you. Then y'all get with somebody else that know a little bit more, but you got to humble yourself to be able to learn, you know what I'm saying, from your people, man. Don't envy nobody that knows more than you. Don't fall in the trap of jealousy or anything like that, man. Because whoever the Most High sent to you, you know what I'm saying, that's who he, that's like the Most High coming to you. You know what I'm saying? To my brothers, the nation of gods and earths. You know what I'm saying? We understand, you know, the black man, the God. We understand that or whatever. You know, I don't go around and call my brothers God, but that spirit. You know what I'm saying? So the Most High coming to the brothers and giving them the right food, man. It's that right food that we got to give to the people, man. And bring us out of condition. You know what I'm saying? Because we the saints that came out the graves, like the Messiah said. And he released the spirit. The saints will come out the grave. You know what I'm saying? We out the grave. We in this time. You know, so we at everybody's grave right now. We trying digging them out. And they land in the damn casket. Like, man, dude, ain't no damn casket. You know what I'm saying?
I'm just sleep.
I'm sleep. I'm all right.
I'm good.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like, man, you in a goddamn grave. You know what I'm saying? Take my hand, man. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people ain't going to take your hand. A lot of people ain't going to take your hand. It's going to make you feel a certain way, but you got to move on to the next one. Plant that seed, move on to the next one, man. You know? And then it start raining like it is outside now. That damn water start filling your grave up. You know what I'm saying? You start getting claustrophobic and damn drowned up in there. And you wonder what's going on. Things get a little too deep before you get too hot. You're going to want to come out that grave. You're going to remember. You know what I'm saying? Damn, I am. I might be in a damn grave. You know what I'm saying? You're going to want to come out. You know? And then you're going to want to find that person that came to you, whatever. You know what I'm saying? So open your ears up to your family out there, man. You know what I'm saying? Everybody... Y'all, we ain't alone out here, man. I know we going through the struggle, whatever. You know what I'm saying? We going through the struggle. We gonna prevail, man. We gonna prevail. And no, I'm not waiting on nobody to come and save me. You know what I'm saying? The Most High is sending men out here to prepare us. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna take time, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm not dealing with no religion. We're not dealing with no religion. I've been reading y'all comments, man. Y'all been saying a lot of slick stuff out there, man. Y'all ain't understanding what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying? No, I'm not dealing with no religion. This is not no cult. You know what I'm saying? That Bible, I look at that Bible, it's my history book. The Most High pulled that veil over my eyes, and I'm able to see. You know what I'm saying? What's really being said, and I seen what the white man tampered with. He ain't do too much. You know what I'm saying? He ain't got the intellect to do it. That's not a white man's book, man. You know what I'm saying? Because it's condemning the white man. You know what I'm saying? King James couldn't have been a homosexual. Why? Because the book is condemning homosexuality. It's as simple as that. How could King James say, I put my name on something and put it out there, and he a homosexual, and the book says, kill homosexuals. You know what I'm saying? Now, he didn't say kill homosexuals, but homosexuals should die.
Yeah, they're going, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They should die. The white man, what he's done to this planet Earth and all the indigenous people around this Earth, hell is coming to him. You know what I'm saying? Everybody who follows with him, the devil's advocates. We watching you too. Them devil's advocates out there. You preachers, you Sambo, coon, damn, ready to damn tap dance and app tap dance the next person, man. You know what I'm saying? Hey, we watching you, man. We're going to start approaching you. I don't give a damn you're a pastor, man. I don't care. I'm approaching you. You know what I'm saying? Y'all here taking my grandma money. I don't play. You know what I'm saying? We don't need to be watching you. You know what I'm saying? So, praise Yahweh. Bahashima Mashiach Yahweh Shah. You know what I'm saying? Black liberation. Black Hebrew liberation. My Hebrew Israelite family out there all over the world. The Most High raising up. My brothers out in London. Bros out there in Europe. My people out there in Africa. We love you. We coming to you soon. Hope I get down with a hug. My people out there on that land. To my brothers all over the United States being raised up in the Caribbean islands, man. You know, hallelujah. How about Hashima Mashiach Awashah? We got next.
All I say is arm yourself with knowledge and keep your eyes open. Do something about your situation.
Another day in the neighborhood. Another day in the neighborhood. Always police. Always police. It's what we working with out here, family. It's what we deal with all the time. Damn police, stay in our damn neighborhood, herding us like damn cattle, man. And we need to start calling the damn police on each other too, man. You know what I'm saying? For nonsense. We can't come to our family. We don't recognize each other as being family, man. We can't come to each other and work things out, man. This is nonsense. Black liberation.
Thirteen, 1-4, it say, if there arise among you a prophet or a dreamer of dreams and give thee a sign or a wonder, and the sign or the wonder come to pass, whereof he spake unto thee, saying, let us go after other gods which thou hast not known. Let us serve them. Now, what we saying here, he say, thou shalt not hearken unto the words of that prophet or that dreamer of dreams. For the Mighty One, your Elohim, proveth you to know whether ye love the Mighty One with all your heart and with all your soul. Ye shall walk with the Mighty One and fear him and keep his commandments and obey his voice, and ye shall serve him and cleave unto him.